How many types of indexes do we have in SQL Server? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, I am going to guide you how many types of indexes do we have in SQL Server. What is the difference between those indexes? What is the syntax of each type of index with one example? Now, before directly telling you what exactly are the types of indexes, first let me tell you what is an index. An index is helpful in order to improve the search performance in our database engine. So that's where index we use it. So if I relate it with a real-time example, the index page that we have in our textbooks, the context or the content page that we have in our textbooks, so it is helpful for us in order to go through that chapter number, page number directly. For example, chapter number 14, which is there in page number 150. So I go to page number 150 directly rather than searching from page number 1. So it increased my searching speed of page number 150 or chapter number 14. Rather than I have to start again from page number 1, no, turn every page to 150th page, then I find chapter number 14. It's a time-taking process. So when I have this index, it is improving my search performance by reducing the time. Alright. So now here, in the same way, whatever you are trying to search, when you are working on a huge data set, when you are working on a huge database, then there might be the chances that the operation or the performance of your SQL Server, when you are trying to search something, which it gets slow. In order to avoid that, we use index. Okay. So now, what are the types of indexes do we have in our SQL Server? There are two types of indexes we have in SQL Server. Number one, we have clustered index. Number two, we have non-clustered index. The difference between these two indexes is very interesting. Okay, so what is this interesting facts that we have between our clustered index and non-clustered index? So let me first explain it to you about a clustered index. Okay, so what clustered index will do, when we are creating one clustered index, it will arrange all the table. For example, on the doctor's table, to the doctor ID column, I am creating a clustered index. Then what it will do? It will arrange everything that we have in that particular table in an alphabetical order, same like a dictionary. So in a dictionary, what do we have starting from alphabet A? What are the vocabulary words till the alphabet Z? So all those will be in an alphabetical order. So in the same way, when we apply a clustered index to any table, then the whole table, what it will do, it will arrange it in an alphabetical order. Now, when I keep a non-clustered index, when I take a non-clustered index, it will collect the data from one place and records at another place. So now if you want to search something using a non-clustered index, so first the data should come from another place to this place, and from this place to it has to show it to you. Are you getting my point? So now the interesting fact is that when the non-clustered index is having the multiple steps in order to get some information or search some information, it is taking a lot of time. So now preferable index is clustered index. So it is faster than a non-clustered index. Now there is another interesting fact that we should all know in this clustered and non-clustered index. When we are creating the table, we give the data types, then we give the constraints. For example, I am creating a employee ID column with an integer as an employee ID data type. Then the constraint, I will give it as a not null, or sometime I will give it as a primary key, or sometime I'll give it as a unique key. So these are the few constraints that I have spoken about. Now the point here is that if I create a column and if I assign it as a primary key constraint, then it automatically creates a clustered index. You don't need to specify, or you don't need to create again a new clustered index. No, when a primary key is already assigned as a constraint to any column, then it will automatically create a clustered index. Then now, if you create a unique constraint to any particular column, it will automatically create a non-clustered index. So again, for example, if you have to create an index using a not null constraint, then yes, you have to create a new index again. But when you are creating a primary key constraint, then automatically it will create a clustered index. Then if you are creating a non-clustered index, then if it is a unique constraint, automatically it will be a non-clustered index. So now, Let me show it to you, the overall view of this cluster and non-cluster index, then we'll discuss it about the syntax and with an example. So as you can see here in the screen, there are two types of indexes. One we have clustered index and another one we have non-clustered index. So here a clustered index, it will arrange the table by alphabetical order and it will specify the physical storage of the table. And if I talk about a non-clustered index, it will collect the data from one place and it records the data in another place. So always this is a time taking process. That's why many of the developers, they prefer going with the clustered index rather than going with a non-clustered index, because it is faster to it. So now SQL Server automatically creates indexes when we use this primary key and unique key constraints. When a unique key constraint is given, it automatically creates a non-clustered index, and if a primary key is given, it automatically creates a clustered index, okay, unless the clustered index, if it is already exist, okay. So now if I show you the syntax for the clustered index, so create, in the same way how we have seen to creating an index, create index, index name on table name to which columns, in the same way create clustered index. We are just adding the word clustered here and rest everything is same, with the index name on which table to which columns. So if I show it to you with a small example, then I am creating the clustered index with the index name, some name called as CD name, okay, clustered index name. So I am creating this to the doctor's table, and under doctor's table I am creating it to the hospital, or if I would like to go with the specialty column that I have in my particular doctor's table. So let me show you the doctor's table as well. So here I am retrieving, I'm fetching the doctor's table records. So select a star from doctor's table. So under this doctor's table, if you see here, we have the specialty column, we have hospital, city, doctor's name, doctor ID and consultation fee column. So what I'm going to do, I'm creating a clustered index for the doctor's particular table to the specialty column. And now what I'm going to do, let me try to execute it. Cannot create more than one clustered index on a table doctors. So drop the existing clustered index. So now what it is telling, this table is already having one clustered index. We cannot create more than one clustered index on a table. So this is what the error that I would like to show it to you. Now, how should we identify, or how should we see to which particular column this particular index is created, clustered index is created? So for that, in order to view the index that it is created, so I'll go with sp underscore help index, then I will go with my table name, which is doctor's table. So now let me see to which particular column this, for this doctor ID column, clustered index is created, because the doctor ID column is having the primary key. As I told you that if you have a primary key, it automatically creates a clustered index. So already a clustered index is created for the doctor ID column because it was assigned with the primary key constraint. Okay. So this is the very important point that you should understand. So now if I try to create the same thing for a non-clustered index, okay, the syntax for the non-clustered index is create non-clustered index, give the index name on which table you would like to create this non-clustered index with those column names, okay. So the same example, I would like to apply it for the non-clustered index. Then if we see here, in the place of clustered, I'm writing non-clustered index. I would like to create this index name on the doctor's table for the specialty column. So if I execute it, commands completed successfully. Successfully the index got created, non-clustered index. Now if I fetch the doctor's table, and if you see here, specialty column is assigned with the non-clustered index which is located, and the doctor ID column which is created while we are creating a table has a primary key constraint. That's where automatically the clustered index got created. So please understand that if a non-clustered index we are creating, we need to make sure that the searching that we are about to do, it takes some time when compared to the clustered index. So when we have a primary key, clustered index is automatically created. When we have a unique key, then non-clustered index is automatically created. If we are not using the primary key or a unique key constraint, and if you want to have a index, then we have to create it manually with this syntax and example that we have seen in this video. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.